Hello, I'm Vince Davis. I am the Cropping Systems Extension Weed Scientist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today, it's late August, and I'm standing in a field of soybeans with severe infestations of volunteer corn. Glyphosate-resistant volunteer corn in these soybeans is a problem for several different reasons. It's not a weed problem that has evolved into high density or problematic situations that's difficult to control in the long term, but in the short term, one, it reduces our yield in that current year. Two, if these plants get large enough to actually produce kernels, it can reduce the quality of our soybean grain at harvest time. Three, it can be a little bit more problematic at harvest time unless you're harvesting after a frost. And four, probably the biggest thing is that it's completely unsightly to be looking at as you drive down the road. And I would say it's one of our most prevalent weeds. I don't know if it's our most problematic, but one of our most prevalent weeds in Wisconsin right now. The fifth issue with volunteer Roundup Ready corn and our soybean is an issue that's the impacts are a little less known, but it is somewhat scary, and that is many of these volunteer corn plants also express low levels of the BT toxin because so many of our corn hybrids are stacked with both glyphosate resistant and BT resistant technologies, and so it's questionable as to what those low levels of BT toxins in these plants do from Western corn rootworm management strategy. And there's been some research work recently published over the last couple years, primarily coming out of Purdue, that faces that issue that you can read up on. So several reasons we are concerned and that we should be looking to control this particular weed. Now the good news with volunteer corn is it's not a difficult weed to control. When we go out with our post-emergence glyphosate, there's two strategies you can use. Really, the one and only strategy, I guess, is to use a post-emergence grass herbicide, or what we call an ACCase inhibitor herbicide that attacks primarily grasses. There's two families of those herbicides, what we call the FOPs and the DIMs. Some popular one is like Quizalofop. On the DIM side, one of our most popular ones are clethodim products and a number of generic clethodim products. Cethoxidim is another product. Of all of the ACase herbicides, cethoxidim is probably one of the more weaker volunteer corn herbicides, but it can get the job done if it's priced right. But most notably is the clethodim products to use in these situations. The two strategies when you add those products in is whether you go out early in your first post-emergence application timing with that grass herbicide or wait till later, because emergence can be a little bit later in some of the clumps of kernels or the ears that get left behind. I'm not sure of those two strategies which are better. I tend to think probably going out earlier. The most important thing is that you're just scouting ahead of those post-emergence applications and determining what your volunteer corn density is. It seems to be real easy at that post-emergence timing to go out and scout and not think you have very many volunteer corn plants out there, because they just don't seem all that numerous until the soybeans get large and you're standing at this time of the year when it's real easy to see these weed escapes. As we're standing in this density right here, we could be looking at 25% to 30% yield loss from this density of volunteer corn right here. As we move over into this area over here, here is an area across this strip here. Here is an area where we did spray clethodim or a grass herbicide at that post-emergence glyphosate timing. It was kind of early. The volunteer corn was all in the 6 to 12 inch range. It was a fairly low rate for control, and you can see we didn't get perfect control out here, but probably enough control that we salvaged our yield to acceptable levels. So again, it's not a difficult weed to control, but it is a weed that is much more unsightly late in the year than early in the year, and so keep that in mind when you're out there scouting and trying to determine whether you want to spend those additional few bucks to pick up this volunteer corn for a variety of the reasons that I discussed.